Orang Indonesia suka sekali makan bakso. Selain dari bahan daging sapi giling, kita juga bisa membuat bakso dari ikan. Selama proses, kita bisa mencatat vocabulary dan nantinya menceritakan kembali tahap-tahap pembuatan bakso ikan ini. In English, basically, we need fish fillet, tapioca starch or cassava flour, water, salt, and other spices. The process is actually quite simple. First, grind the fillet until smooth using a blender or food processor. Then, mix the flour and water slowly. Use the spoon to help you mix it. Add some salt and other spices. Boil some water in a pan. You can add some bay leaves or a stalk of lemongrass to give you delicious smell. Shape the mix into balls using these two spoons and drop them into the boiling water. Finally, wait until they float and they're done. Jadi prosesnya sebetulnya sangat simple. Giling fillet sampai halus memakai blender atau food processor. Campur tepung dan air pelan-pelan pakai sendok untuk mengaduknya. Tambahkan garam dan rempah lainnya. Lalu kita rebus air di dalam panci. Tambahkan beberapa helai daun salam atau sebatang serai untuk memberi aroma yang sedap. Bentuk adonannya menjadi bulatan-bulatan memakai 2 sendok ini, lalu masukkan ke dalam air yang sedang mendidih. Tunggu sampai mengapung dan selesai. Matang deh! Some words related to making fish balls or fillet, potongan daging atau ikan tanpa tulang. Make from scratch, membuat sesuatu dari nol. Food processor, pengolah makanan. Food strainer, saringan. Boil, merebus. Tapioca starch, tepung kanji. Tapioca flour, tepung tapioca. Bay leaf, daun salam. Salt, garam. Water, air. This is fillet. As a noun, we pronounce it fillet, like sleigh, means potongan ikan tanpa duri. The seller said it was barramundi fillet or fillet ikan kakap. To be honest, I'm not really sure. You know, when it's fillet, you cannot be sure that it is all barramundi, but probably mixed with other kind of fish. Maybe with ikan nila or tilapia fish. During the strong wind, it is harder for the fishermen to go fishing in the sea. So we also get our supplies from freshwater fish farms. Anyway, this smells good. That's the most important thing. When you buy fish fillet, make sure you can still smell a little bit sweetness in this raw fish, which means it is still fresh. We will make everything from scratch, all fresh ingredients, fish fillet, salt, water, tapioca flour, extra spices like bay leaves or daun salam, garlic, bawang putih, candle nuts, kemiri, and coriander or ketumbar. We have the word ground, like in ground fish and ground coriander. In active form, the verb grind, which means menggiling, we will change it into passive voice, so it changes from grind into ground. Menggiling menjadi digiling atau dihaluskan. We can use food processor, meat grinder, or traditional ulekan to grind them. So we have ground fish or ikan giling and ground coriander or ketumbar bubuk. I don't have the exact recipe, so you can make using any ingredients you have in the fridge. So mix them all, shape into the balls, and drop them into the boiling water. Let it boil for a few minutes until they float. Put them on a strainer to remove the excess water. Done! Okay, it's raining. I love the rain. Fillet ikan yang tersedia di pasaran kota Semarang sini umumnya adalah dari ikan kakap putih, kata penjualnya sih. Tetapi tidak selalu begitu, karena ada musim di mana para nelayan tidak bisa melaut karena cuaca. Di situ kita bisa juga memakai ikan air tawar, seperti ikan nila. Pastikan pilih ikan yang segar, bisa kita tambahkan rempah segar lain seperti bawang, kemiri, dan ketumbar, biar mantap. Yang jelas kamu bisa modifikasi sendiri bahannya tergantung apa yang ada di dalam kulkas. Biarkan direbus selama beberapa menit, tunggu sampai mengapung, lalu tiriskan dengan saringan. That will be very good food for a rainy season like this. Happy cooking!